Pa je, zadnja utakmica je stvarno, odigrali smo odličnu utakmicu protiv Škotske na njihovom terenu. Sjećanja su super. S tom utakmicom smo se plasirali u drugi krug natjecanja i kao što sam rekao, sjećanja te utakmice su dobre. Bila je teška utakmica, kao što je uvijek kad god igramo protiv Škotske. Eto, zabio sam taj lijep gol i to je to.
Yeah, the last match against Scotland is in excellent memories for all of us. It was important game for us because we qualified for the next round. I remember that it was a difficult game against a tough opponent, which is always the case against Scotland. I was happy to score a really nice goal, and that's what I remember from that game.
Look, at the results so far would suggest that your team are strong favourites for this match. Scotland have struggled so far in this Nations League section. How do you assess and read that? Do you have to be careful of the danger Scotland may have here?
Pa, sigurno da rezultati Škotske možda u zadnje vrijeme nisu najbolji, ali to ništa ne znači. Ovo je nova utakmica. Naš skor sa Škotskom nije pozitivan. Kad se pogleda sve, mislio sam da je puno bolji, ali evo prije sam saznao da imamo samo jednu pobjedu od 6 utakmica, tako da sam taj skor pokazuje koliko nam je teško igrati protiv Škotske, koje su uvijek fanatična, borbena ekipa, gdje igraju u dobrim klubovima po širom Velike Britanije, tako da nas očekuje jako teška utakmica i naravno, igramo kući pred našim navijačima i prihvaćamo ulogu favorita, ali da očekujemo laganu utakmicu, to definitivno ne. Znamo da će biti teško, ali vjerujemo u nas i nadam se da ćemo odigrati veliku utakmicu i doći do 3 boda koja su nam jako važna.
Obviously, Scotland results haven't been the best last few matches, but that doesn't mean anything for the game tomorrow. We don't have a very good score against Scotland historically. We only have 1 win in 6 games, which shows that we have a difficult time playing against Scotland. It's always a very passionate, tough team to play against. They have players in the clubs across Great Britain, so we know it's going to be a difficult game, but we are playing at home with our fans. And we accept the role of the favorites in the game tomorrow. We understand it won't be easy, but we have high belief in our team. We hope to play a really, really good match and go for 3 points that we want to achieve tomorrow.
Luca, you have played against Scotland and against Scottish clubs a few times in your career. What are the qualities you think of when you think of Scottish players?
Osim nogometne kvalitete, naravno, što moraš posjedovati da bi igrao u velikim klubovima, kao što imaju oni igrača što igraju u odličnim klubovima. Po meni je ta njihova borbenost, ta fanatičnost, to zajedništvo gdje me u jednu ruku posjećaju na nas. Tako da vidi se da im je igranje za reprezentaciju od velike časti i važnosti, tako da u tom nekom segmentu me s tom borbenošću, s tom nekom, ajmo reći, imaju tu pripadnost prema svojoj zemlji i tu na neki način me posjećaju na nas.
Obviously, I think you need to have football quality, which is the case for anybody that wants to play good football, and that's the case with Scotland as well. But what I see as the main qualities are what I mentioned, passion, toughness, togetherness, and in a way they remind me of Croatian team in some ways, because you can tell that playing for Scotland is a great honor and it has huge importance for the players. You can see a certain patriotism, and that's what I see very similar to Croatian team.
Look, when we traveled to Zagreb yesterday, our taxi driver told us Martin Baturina was the new Luka Modric. Is that true? And will we see some of that when Celtic play Dinamo in the Champions League soon?
Pa dobro, vidjet ćemo. Martin treba imati svoj put, da je veliki talent, to definitivno je. I sad je samo na njemu. Da radi, da trenira, da uči. I ja vjerujem da će jednoga dana biti nositelj hrvatske reprezentacije, kao što sam ja ovih godina bio, tako da vjerujem u njega. Ima stvarno strašan potencijal, kvalitetu, talent, ali na kraju opet je sve do njega. Mora raditi, mora svakim danom se poboljšavati da bi napravio veliku karijeru.
We'll see. He's a great talent, but he needs to work, he needs to train well, he needs to work really hard at the training sessions. I believe that he's going to become a key player for Croatian team in the future, like I was, like I am. He has a lot of potential, a lot of quality, a lot of talent, but as I said, most of all, he needs to keep on working and keep on improving every day.
Luka, tomorrow would be your 181st appearance for Croatia, at 39 years of age. Where does this desire to keep going and keep performing at the very highest level come from?
Pa prije svega iz ljubavi prema nogometu i prema Hrvatskoj. Jednostavno, za mene igranje za reprezentaciju je nešto posebno, velika čast. I to me dalje drži motiviranog i to me gura naprijed. Tako da je to je primaran razlog zašto i dalje sam tu, zašto i dalje sam motiviran da igram na visokom nivou.
Above everything, it's love for football and for Croatia. For me, playing for the national team is something special, is the highest of honors, and that's what motivates me to play my best going forward.
Hi, Luka. Tomorrow, Scotland will probably play a goalkeeper who is 41 years old. You must admire that, and unusual for somebody older than yourself to be playing on the same pitch.
Oh, my. Pa dobro, naravno da je, znamo Gordona još od prije i odličan je golman i da još i dalje se natječe i da i dalje igra je stvarno velika stvar za njega i za Škotsku. Tako da lijepo je znat da će biti neko stariji od tebe na terenu.
I know Gordon from before. Obviously, he's an excellent goalkeeper, and it's a big thing for both him and Scotland that he's still playing, and it's going to be nice that somebody is actually older than me on the pitch.
Hi, Luka, could I ask, Croatia is often looked on as the gold standard for small nations in world football. Can you tell us what is the secret of Croatia's success, and what can Scotland learn from the Croatian experience?
Tajna, teško je reći neku tajnu. Mislim da ta ljubav koja nas, igranje, čast igranja za reprezentaciju, mislim da je to ono najvažnije za sve ove naše uspjehe što smo napravili ovih godina. Osim, naravno, trebaš imati kvalitetu, u nekim trenucima se trebaju posložiti neke stvari, ali sama ta želja, ta volja kad se dođe igrati za reprezentaciju, za nas je to kao neki praznik, ajmo reći, i stvarno dolazimo s guštom, sa velikim motivom da predstavljamo Hrvatsku na najbolji mogući način, da razveselimo naše ljude i to su razlozi zašto je Hrvatska uvijek u vrhu europskog i svjetskog nogometa, pogotovo zadnjih godina, tako da to je to ono što nas gura naprijed i što sigurno osim te kvalitete što moraš imati je ta želja, volja, pripadnost igranja za svoju zemlju.
I think for us it's this love passion, honor of playing for your nation. I think that's what's most important for the previous success of Croatian team. Of course, you need to have quality, sometimes a little bit of luck at major tournaments, but I think this passion for each of us when we come to the national team, it's like a holiday, not in a relaxing kind of way, but how important it is for each player. We want to make Croatians proud when we play, and that's what keeps us in the European and world top for all these years, especially lately. As I said, passion, desire, and all the similar words that you can find.
Evo ga, konačno hrvatsko pitanje. Na hrvatskom. Kapitane, poštovanje, što mislite ili ocjenjujete da će biti posebno izazovno sutrašnjoj utakmici, samim time što će biti ključno s naše strane napraviti da se dođe do željenog rezultata?
Pa prije svega nadam se da možemo ponoviti igru kao što je to bila protiv Portugala i protiv Poljske. Bez obzira što smo izgubili od Portugala, mislim da smo odigrali dosta dobru utakmicu. Protiv Poljske smo samo potvrdili taj trend da u ovoj novoj formaciji da se osjećamo ugodno i prije svega bit će važno da ponovimo takve igre. Strpljenje po meni. Morat ćemo biti strpljivi jer pretpostavljamo da ćemo mi biti ti koji ćemo diktirati tempo gdje ćemo imati više loptu u nogama i gdje ćemo češće napadati, tako da ćemo morati biti strpljivi, puno se kretati i stvarati šanse. Tako da to su te neke stvari.